Okay, so that's it, you know? So then, now go out here and say, I'm going to play, you know? I'm going to play a little bit for you, okay?
All right.
I'm sorry about that. Is that live? Ooh, I got feedback down, okay.
Anyway, Rich Severson, everybody. And Gary Newmark.
I just want to tell you, I'm so happy to have these cats up here. This is going to be a lot of fun. We're going to try to do a little blues, a typical type of blues that Jimmy Smith used to lay down west. You know, you guys know about West Montgomery?
Yeah.
He was one of the greatest, you know. And, you know, Jimmy Smith and West Montgomery, they were like soup and sandwich, you know. And so if you ever see this album, it's called James and West, and it's the title tune from the record. You'll know it's the original record because Jimmy Smith is eating one side of a hot dog, and West Montgomery, he's on the other side. He's eating the other side. When they got to the middle, I don't know what they did, but they had to work it out, you know? We're going to do James and West, something like this. It goes like this. Thank you. Happy to be up here with these cats, you know, with Gary and Rich. If you don't mind, I'd like to try some original compositions of mine, a couple of them anyway. And like Tom was telling you, I have been very fortunate to go to Paris in my 20s, my late 20s, and I worked and saved up, and I saved up all my dough, and I had this dream to go to Paris. I don't know why, because I cannot speak any French, you know. But it was a dream of mine, so I heard about the Concorde jet, you know, and I saved up my money and I bought a ticket on the Air France Concorde jet. And you know, they retired that airplane, but it went twice the speed of sound. And I took that jet, and it changed my life. Now I am supersonic, and nobody can take that away from me. You know? So it took 3 hours and 26 minutes from JFK to Charles de Gaulle. And I got there so fast that it was really weird, man, because I had never been to Europe before. So I thought, this is what I want to do. Travel first class, because I never get a chance to go back over to Europe. I didn't know. I thought maybe this is the only time. So I went over there. I bought the ticket on the Concorde, and I checked into a hotel. My friends, the Santana Band, came over. I met up with them the next day, and I stayed in the left bank, and I checked in after a while. After I blew a bunch of dough in an expensive hotel, I went into this place called the Hotel de Saint, and I stayed 56 days in that hotel. And like Tom was telling, I had a writer's block, you know. Well, I met a young lady my first full day in Paris, and I found out later her name was Lydia. Lydia didn't want to talk to me. I was there with my tomato juice, and it was the most expensive tomato juice I ever bought. You know? I bet a few of you folks have been to Paris. There's a place called Café Audu Magot. And that's where I was. I'd sit outside, and I bought my little tomato juice, and this young lady sitting next to me. She had a pile of books. I tried to talk to her. She was hiding behind her book, you know. And she said, she was telling me no English, you know, she couldn't speak English. I was very persistent. Finally, she started talking. It turned out she could speak like five languages with, you know, perfect. And her name was Lydia, but she was very sad, even with all those languages. She was sad, and I went back to my hotel room. I had a little tiny Casio keyboard, little thing, and I could pick out some melodies on there. I wrote this little melody, it's a simple melody, and I put it on my first album, and it's called Lydia's Tune. Now, I don't know where Lydia's at someday. Maybe she'll pick up the album. Lydia's gone, but the song is still here. You know? And it goes something like this. This is a bossa nova.
Thank you. Thank you.